The Holderness family is proud to present A Swifty Dad Trying So Hard.
You listening to the new album?
Yep, Dad's listening to it too.
Yeah, a little internet research. I saw that Thank You Amy was a diss track.
Yeah, I wonder who Amy is and like what she did to Taylor.
It's about Kim Kardashian? Who the heck is Amy then?
I should have known that. Come on, Penn, do better.
How about, you know, her referencing Travis Kelce's dad? Huh? Yeah? Dads are pretty great, right? They love you very much. Dads will do anything to make a connection with her. Daughter, I love you so much, and this is how I'm showing you. Did you hear her mention Charlie Puth? Hey, you know, honey, I've been saying that Charlie Puth slaps for years, right? Oh, no one says slaps anymore. No way out. We got another one. I guess you and your brother are both playing Fortnite today, huh? Because you're playing the song and he's playing the video game. You know, I'm going to let you listen. It's a big day for you, so peace out. Get it? Remember, because the things you did at the Grammys and...
Aren't dads the best? And now, from Times Square, it's That Kevin Show.
Somewhere in the bowels of the city that never sleeps,
Kevin McCullough, radio host with Salem Media,
is a man also not sleeping.
Syndicated radio talk show host Kevin McCullough.
And that guy would like a word with you.
Many of you know him from as Nostradamus.
Of course That Kevin Show is going to be great. The only thing that could be greater, of course, would be That Donald Show. But we don't have that, so we have That Kevin Show.
Featuring the music of Dick Tunney and the Dream in Color Orchestra. Still to come, she wrestles government on behalf of small businesses like a pro, Linda McMahon. A new episode of House Squatters on the way, freeing human slaves, and Maren Morris joins Teddy Swims in the spotlight. And now, from Times Square, where even the muggers are showing kindness these days by mailing back their stolen IDs, here's the...
Incredibly kind, I would say. I mean, for a mugger in Times Square, at least. Kevin McCullough, welcoming you into hour number two. Man, have we got a lot for you. The Babylon Bee back second week in a row with some sketch comedy we've got coming up. And of course, thanks to Penn Holderness for the little bit of Dad and Taylor humor there at the start of the hour. Plus, Teddy Swim still coming back. Let's get to the news.
Assignment Desk Weekend, I'm Kevin McCullough. A series of brand new polls are out showing President Trump faring quite well against his 2024 opponent. He's taken new leads with Catholic, African-American, and Latino voters. And on Friday, the newest national poll showed a 12-point lead for the 45th president and pointing to an increasingly likely contest between the last two administrations is already in full swing. In response, the White House has reportedly ordered at least 15 more 3 a.m. semi-deliveries full of cartons of ballots for delivery at 3 a.m. on November 6th. Minnesota and Michigan, two of the places those deliveries are scheduled for, also continue to be the only, quote, two-state solution that President Biden seems to be focused on. Researchers are revealing that a new study is reporting that controlling one's anger is actually very key to long-term heart health. In a related story, actor Robert De Niro has been put on permanent heart monitoring from now through the end of the election this fall. Appearing on MSNBC on Friday, the very old actor claimed that President Trump, a lifelong New Yorker like himself, is one of the worst bullies in recorded history. The actor then went on to say that he'd like to punch Trump in the face. Then he called the 45th president Hitler and promised that bad things were coming if the nation reelected him. Assignment Desk Weekend would have loved to have had a follow-up question for Mr. De Niro. The question would be, Do you mean things similar to Biden and AOC's actual support of actual Nazis, actually storming the university campuses, actually saying to gas the Jews? Speaking of actors, Emily Blunt and her co-star Ryan Gosling are speaking out as Hollywood elites everywhere are expressing concern over the continued use of artificial intelligence in the production of major motion picture films. It seems that the acting community's chief concern is, what if the AI is a better actor than we are? It's legit. And finally, security concerns abound this weekend when another actor was seen randomly roaming the West Wing of the White House. A recipient of the Medal of Honor this weekend, Star Wars actor Mark Hamill, famous for his role as Luke Skywalker, seemed dazed and confused.
I just got to meet the president. He gave me these aviator glasses. You know, I called him Mr. President. He said, you can call me Joe. And I said, can I call you Obi-Wan Kenobi?
Sure. Luke, may the Fourth be with you. I'm Kevin McCullough.
I'm 25 years old, and I pretty much just vape all day.
I'm Crackhead Steve. I'm 27. I play the guitar. Sometimes I spin a street sign on the corner for some extra spending cash. And I do crack.
Kayla and Crackhead Steve are squatters. Their budget is $0.
I'm looking for something open concept with maybe some wood paneling. A pool would be nice. But really, it's just anywhere where someone else is paying the mortgage and I can live indefinitely with full protection of the law.
I'm just looking for a place to do crack.
So this is definitely more of a starter home, but every squatter has to start somewhere. It's got all of your basics, running water, electricity, Wi-Fi. And the best part is, it's all paid for by the homeowner.
Look at this wood paneling. Oh, and there's a cozy little corner over there. I could just see myself sitting there, taking in the sunshine, not paying the mortgage.
Hey, babe! I found this really cool room to do crack in. Come on!
So what do we think of this cozy little starter home?
Well, I did really like the wood paneling.
Yeah, and the crack spot.
What's the asking price for this house?
Well, it can all be yours to squat in today for just $0.
That's not bad, but it is a little small for what we're looking for. Maybe we should see what else is out there.
Kayla, Crackhead Steve, get ready to meet your suburban pool paradise.
Wow. I was a little disappointed that there wasn't any wood paneling in there, but this pool, it more than makes up for it. I could see us squatting here for a long time. Maybe even starting a little squatting family.
Well, I don't know, Kayla. What if I'm trying to do crack and it falls out in the pool? It's gonna ruin it. I, for one, am not convinced.
Well, I like it.
So I don't know if this will sway your decision, but it's a real squatter's market right now. You can move in today for just $0.
Maybe we should look at one more option.
Well, guys, what do we think?
Oh my, yes.
Yeah, this is sick. This is sick.
So I think this definitely checks all of your boxes. Wood paneling, a pool outside, and plenty of room for activities. Everything to do whatever it is you might want to do in here.
Where did you get that?
The guy in the fridge. That's so good.
The only downside is, unfortunately, the homeowners haven't left on vacation yet.
Who are you guys and how did you get in here?
But don't worry, I'm already two steps ahead of them. I've signed up for magazines in your name for you to establish residency so we can kick them out of here.
Aw, Mrs. Crackhead Steve? I like the sound of that. Mm-hmm. But isn't this place out of our price range?
Get this, it's just at the top of your budget of just $0.
Which home will Kayla and Crackhead Steve choose? Will it be small but cozy? Middle class pool paradise? or the dream crack mansion? Let's find out.
We really liked all the homes, but in the end, we just had to go with the massive mansion.
We need to check it out.
We couldn't resist the pool, the wood paneling, and the fact that these homeowners, Dan and Cindy, are just gonna like pay the mortgage while we just hang out.
And do crack.
All right, guys, are you ready for the best part of the show?
Yeah.
Would you like to help me do the honors?
Officer, arrest those homeowners!
What nerves?
Are you serious?
Ooh.
Oh my gosh! Oh my gosh! I can't, this is our house!
Ready or not, we'll be right back.